Welcome to this video. In this video, we are going to see formula editing, filters, customized filters, and slicers, VLOOKUP, HLOOKUP, and XLOOKUP, index match functions. So the first one we will take formula editing. In case if you are using any complex formulas and the data which will be implemented to calculate some value using some formulas. If you want to see how the formula is evaluated, we can make use of formula auditing, formula evaluation option from Excel. See, here we have a small simple table. In this table, some data set has given the boat rent and boat fuel, life waste and the picnic. So these are some data given. Individual data, right? So these data we are calculating here as cost per person, and group size is 8 members. So this is a simple data, and we will see how we are calculating that. So if you are selecting these values in the bottom side, we can see the average is 253.67 rupees. The sum is 1522 rupees. Now, if you are dividing that, we will be getting this value. Okay, by pressing function key F2, we can see the group size, the cost per person calculated as round of function used here. C10 is this value, 761 divided by C12 is 8. So, if you are dividing those values, we are getting this 96 rupees per head. Okay, so I'm not teaching how the formula is evaluating, how we can track the formula is executing. For that, we have to go to the formulas. In this formula auditing group, we can find evaluate formula. You just select that, a pop-up window, a dialog box comes up. Here, the same formula is showing here, roundup function C10/C12,0, right? In C10, bottom we can notice one underline. That means the pointer is showing C10. Bottom, you can see these buttons, evaluate button, step in, and close. See, if I'm pressing the evaluate, the C10 value, you notice here, C10 value, C10 is this one. The 761 will be substituted to this C10, you see. C10 substituted. Now, C12 has got underline. Now, once again, click the evaluate symbol. The C12 is 8 also going to be substituted here. See, 8 also substituted. Now the line goes to 761/8. Once again click the evaluate, that value will be calculated 95.125, right? And the underline also showing the complete. There is no more calculations. The roundup function only will be implemented. Now you click on the evaluate. Now we're getting 96 rupees. That is what here calculated. So how the value is a substituted to each and every variable, we can notice. In case any value wrongly substituted or some other thing, you are not able to understand the formula, by using this evaluate formula, we can understand step by step. So this is what the evaluation, formula evaluation helps us. And here you can notice that race precedence is nothing but to calculate that which cells involved, that also can be seen. You see, I am selecting 96 rupees and just click this. Now the 761 and 8, both the things are showing here. If you are moving, 1 minute, I am showing this clearly. I am selecting this because you can understand this. Now select this, keep the mouse pointer 96, go to trace precedence. You see, this also showing 96, the 8 also showing 96, right? So like that, the 96 having one formula, in that they both variables are involved. So this is what we can see. If you want to remove the arrows, you can go to this place, remove arrows, the arrows will be removed. That's it. So this is what the evaluate formula is working. Now we are moving to the next one, filtering. Here we have a sample data. For your easy understanding, I am removing these data, clearing all, right? So here we have some data set. In this data set, I want to sort. In what way we can sort? Here, see the UK, USA, two countries repeatedly showing here. Only UK candidates, otherwise USA candidates, otherwise some dates candidates comes under the same category of years. Or we can say above some amount, above some numbers also can be given. See, for that I am copying this data, control C, I am keeping the mouse pointer somewhere here, and paste special. I am copying all, see, all copied here. Now I am selecting this row title, column titles, and going to home menu. You can see last one, editing. Here you can find sort and filters. You just click that, you can see one filter funnel type icon. You click that. Now we are able to see the sorting icon, the sorting symbol comes to each and every column, right? So by using this list, you can see what are the data available. Here also you can see, here also if you are clicking this, you can see USA and UK. So only two data repeatedly presenting here. If you are coming to this place, you can see all the data, right? In case if you want to see only USA, you uncheck the US, UK, equip the check mark only to the USA. You will be now seeing only USA candidates, right? So this is what we can make use of, this sorting option. Now you uncheck this, put only tick to UK. Now see, UK students or UK candidates only displaying. So this is the way we can make use. In case if you are selecting this one, both the data also will be selected. Now see, like that, here also you can see these are the data. If you want to give some colors, otherwise some largest to smallest, like that, see, you can select this, it is been sorted. Now see, once again go there, and largest to smallest. Now see, reverse, the largest number comes top, and this thing, the smallest number goes the bottom. So this also a kind of sorting. Here also alphabet order you can sort, descending order also you can sort, right? In case if you are giving some colors, I'm giving some colors to randomly some students, okay, and another color using different colors. Now see, you go there, sort by color. Which color you want to see? Yellow first. You see, yellow comes first. Now I want to see the magenta first. You take the magenta, magenta comes top. Otherwise no fill, see, no fill, normal without filling comes top. So this is the way different kind of the filtering, sorting also available, okay, right? So the age wise, here also we can see only 2016 I want to see. You see, only 2016 candidates are presented. So this is the way we can make use of this filter. In this filter you can notice one more thing, custom sort. What is the custom sort? Before that I will remove all the filters. One more thing I forget to mention here. See, here we are giving, we are implementing one filter, right? I'm selecting all. Now everything becomes normal. Now this is the ascending order, okay, ascending order. In this ascending order, I have one more filter also applying USA. See, okay, ascending order also implemented, at the same time USA also implemented. Two filters at a time it is taking, isn't it? So more than one filter also we can implement. So this is how it is working. If you want to remove all the filters, just go back to the filters. Once again click the funnel, everything becomes normal. That symbol also gone, right? Now we are going to see the custom sort. More than one also we can implement. See, I am selecting these columns, I am selecting this data set, I'm going to this custom sort. In this custom sort, you can understand add level, delete level, these are some options available. What I want to see, I want to sort based on sales. See, sales is here, last name is here, country, four data columns are there. Four columns names also available here. I want to sort based on country. You select country. The next one is country values. That values should be A to Z or Z to A, right? Z to A in the sense, both the things are U, starts with U, but the second character S and K will be evaluated. See, I'm selecting Z to A, descending order. You just say okay. USA comes first, UK goes second. Okay, so this is the way. And one more thing, I want to implement more than one filter. Just add one more level. After country, I want to go with the sales. The sales values should be greater than or largest to smallest. See, the first one is implemented, this one USA. After that, this one is sorting. So if you are looking at the USA students, USA candidates, this is the highest number, this is the lowest figure, isn't it? So descending order, ascending, biggest to smallest, second level also implemented. Now the same way I want to implement one more. You just go to the customize, and one more level also I'm going to add. In this one more level, I want to sort the first column, last name. This is last name column, no, last name, based on colors, font colors or cell colors. Those are, these are the cell colors. You select the cell colors. In this, in that cell color, yellow first, yellow on top. Say okay. Okay. Now see, in this USA first one, in this ascending order, in this ascending order, yellow comes first and this goes last. In between, one more filter also is a first priority, second priority. In this priority, this thing is sorted. So yellow goes top, this blue color comes last. This is the way we can use this. Okay, we will finish the slicers. Okay, so this is another data set, slicers example. This data set is a Titanic data set. In this data set, how many data are there? We just browse down, just to verify. See, 891 data are here. Just seeing 892 data records are there here. All right. So now we are going to see slices. How we can use the slices? The previously we used some customized sorting or more than one criteria also implemented to see the filtering mechanism, isn't it? But here we can use the slices for a different easy user-friendly display of the data. This is the data set. So we are having like this. First of all, what we have to do, the data set, extra information in the sense unwanted data, unwanted rows and columns, unfilled entries should be removed. I am selecting these two rows and I am deleting. See, two rows deleted. Now we are going to check the bottom, control downward arrow. We are coming down. See, here some data are missing. Here also some data are missing. So here some data, only few data are here. So this also we are not going to use. This is not the complete record. So that is why this also can be deleted. You select those columns, those rows, and go to this place and you can clear contents or simply clear all or clear formats also. Okay. So just we have removed that those records. Now control arrow, we can go top. Now this data set should be converted into data table. For that, what we have to do, select the data table, click somewhere and go to insert. Here we can see table. You just click the table, this complete data set will become a table structure. Okay, it adopts the table structure. This is what already we did. I will show you some examples so that easily you can understand. Okay, I'm copying this data. Moving to fresh sheet, I'm keeping the mouse pointer somewhere and going to paste special. In the paste special, I want the data only values, not formats. Okay, now see, I'm getting the data without any table format, right? Right, so this is the table format. For easy purpose, I'm minimizing this. You can see within the screen, right? So the top side, bottom side, if there is any rows, that should be removed. Already we have removed, right? So here, you just keep the mouse pointer somewhere and go to the insert button, insert menu item. Here you can see the table. You just click the table. Now it is asking the range, your table located from which point to which point. It's a A1 to 892 rows, isn't it? So this is the reference. You just say okay, this becomes the table format. Okay, so once it is becoming table format, the addition, deletion, all these things also will be automatically also. Automatically also we can do some options. So it's an advantage, right? So first of all, we have to do a table structure. Then we have to go to insert. Here you can see slices. So where is the slices? Insert and go to the filters. Here we can see slices. You just click the slices. Why it is showing? Our cursor point is outside the data table, so that is why it is not giving. You just bring down, bring the cell, the cursor within the table, and now you click the slicer. Now you can see all the columns names are here. Now I want to select gender as well as passenger class and survived or not, and cabin number. Okay, right, see four dashboards given by the Excel. I'm just minimizing so that I can place this also in easy view. Okay, so these are the dashboards. On these four criteria I want to select, otherwise I want to show. I want to give the explanation on this table. See, here you can click female. See, this is a female column. Where is that? This is a gender column. Male, female, everybody is there. Just if you're selecting this female, this column shows only female. You see, only female. So female, this many participants, passengers, this many passengers. This is the their data. We can give some explanation. Now if you want to see only male, we can see the male. And in the male, survived, see, all these column is only zeros, survived, passengers, dead passengers. So this is how we can select the one in survived column, only one will be selected. So we can give some projection about this data. We can describe the data. The class also we can see, the male already selected, and these are the dead candidates, and cabin also P class. The P class is here. Where is that? Here is the P class. See, if you select this automatically, the symbol, the filter symbol also included. It shows the filtering mechanism easily we can do in a user friendly way. We need not go to any menu. We need not select anything. We need not give any customized sorting also, filtering also. Directly we can use with the help of the dashboards, right? So this is how we can do. If you want to delete any filters, simply see in the top side, top right top corner, the funnel symbol and the X mark. You just click the X mark, the dialog box that will be deleted. That the filter is cancelled. If you want to remove this, you just keep that and delete key. If you want to delete survived or vice the class, you just click on that and press del key from the keyboard, that will be deleted. Only two dashboards are there. If you want to add one more dashboard, simple. You just go to insert, go to slicers. Still it is showing. You can select any other thing. Passengers ID. You see, passenger ID also come on to the screen. Now we can make use of this. Right? So this is how we can make use of the dashboard. So the presentation time will be saved. The viewers, the listeners also won't distracted. They can concentrate what you are telling about the data. all these things will be very focusedly we can give the presentation. So this is how this filters is working. Okay, I hope this video is very helpful for you. Thank you for watching.